Welcome back, and joining us on the show now is Prathamesh Malia of Angel Commodities. Prathamesh, hi. What is your own sense when it comes to the metals as a sector? Because we've seen very choppy moves come in there, but surprisingly, we have seen not just nickel, but lead and copper in some sense hold on as well today.
Yes, Manisha, I think the volatility has been the characteristics of the entire commodity space, and not sparing the metals. You rightly mentioned out nickel is being very volatile. But then if you want to pick me one commodity from the metal space, I think I would play safe with copper, because it's moving in a very tight range, 460 on the downside, 470 on the upside. But if you really want to trade in the commodity, I think the base is to be 460 on the lower side, and the higher side would be the 470. So you play your own moves depending on this particular narrow range as far as M6 price is concerned. Nickel would be very volatile. I think 1050 is what they're looking on the MCX, but yes, volatility will eat you down, so do not continuously stay longs on this particular metal.
What is your own sense on the gold and silver prices? Because today is a strong day. Even as the US dollar is trading at a 6-month highs, we have seen equal amount of buying come in for the precious metals.
Yes, Manisha, I think if you look at the options concentration, the M6, 31,600 and 31,100 are the two areas where, as far as gold is concerned, are two key areas wherein all the options are concentrated. So in that sense, it gives a direction that 31,600 on the higher side is the maximum price for gold, while on the downside it is 31,100 is what we're looking at. So again, it's a play of a range as far as gold price concerned. But yes, we are not bullish on gold for that matter. Silver as well, if you want to play in gold, I think we would better be on the sell side. I think the 31,000 looks very much likely as far as near term trade is concerned, while as far as silver goes, we are expecting correction of 600 to 700 rupees. So I think we would better sell both the metals.
All right. And one final word before we let you go on. The crude oil price is also trading around that 75. 75 actually has been holding in the global markets. Do you see some encouragement to go long around these levels?
Manisha, if you're really a trader in oil, I think in this falling market, you would burn your hands if you be on the long side at this point in time. I think this is just a falsified move, which you're today seeing almost 1% up on the MCX. So I think you would better sell in oil, because there is still room, more room for oil prices to fall towards 63 mark as far as WTI is concerned, while Brent trading at $75, I think there is still more room towards $71. On the MCX, I think 4,400 is what we're looking at. So I would not go longs if I would be a trader in this particular commodity.
All right, Prathamesh, we'll let you go at that. So most sell calls actually coming in for the commodities market. Buy, of course, in the metal space, but not so much in the precious metals or the energy sector. But that's all the time that we have on this edition of Closing Bell. After the bell comes up next.